Excellent. Let's go. We're the only show in America that has its in-house psychotherapist.
Dude, why do we have that?
Because of all the nuttiness. And we met Jill Payne, guys, 2 years ago, I think, by now. She's a psychotherapist. She's a Houstonian. Met her through our friends at Houston Baptist University when was on a web project. And we started chatting. I'm like, you need to come on the show. You're good. Jill, via Skype, how are you?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. And that's good till Friday. You know what, folks? You can say that till Friday.
Well, I usually say Happy New Year because to me, right, it's all of January.
Okay. All right. So up until the Super Bowl, you can say Happy New Year to people. Jill Payne is our, she's a board certified licensed professional counselor, certified relationship specialist, part of the American Psychotherapy Association, blah, 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 blah. Okay, here's the therapy. Well, you go first because the Trump victory is still messing with people's heads. They still can't get over it.
Right. And I was in Washington, D.C. visiting my parents, and the news in Washington is quite different than the news here in Houston because in Washington it is all about politics. It's just political. And so Sunday and on the front page, and I have it here, this is what started me thinking about what we're going to talk about today. And it says Trump-Putin relationship to soon be tested. And then in our newspaper, we had something with the Office of Congressional Ethics, and all this turmoil is going on. And I wanted to explain to people that this anxiety that's going on is called existential anxiety. And what this does is it motivates us to fulfill our needs. So Maslow, who was a psychiatrist, and he had a theory, a model, and it was the hierarchy of needs, which is he wanted to find out how people are motivated. So this is the reason Trump got elected, and even Bernie Sanders was up there, because people are not getting their needs met. And the five basic needs, do you want to hear them?
Yeah, hit me.
Okay. Well, they're not all basic. The first two are basic. One is physiological, and that if we don't have and meet those needs, Sam, we die. It's air, water, food, shelter, clothing, sex, sleep. Maybe we could live without sex. Well, not really, because that reproduces. So so that's number one. And then there's...
I'm sorry. You keep in mind, I'm like a 17-year-old boy when those topics come up. But anyway, keep going. I'm just like, she said sex.
Well, whenever I want to get attention, I just say the word sex, and people, their ears light up. So number two is safety and security, which is personal, financial, health. Then there's three, which is wanting to belong, the social needs, love and belonging. And then there's four, esteem, which is self-respect. And then self-actualization, which is basically, he says, most of us don't meet that. That's when you become independent and you feel really good and can go out and do anything without depending on anybody else. So I want to compare that. He just compared it with humans. I want to compare it with the United States. So what we have here is we've got a lot of turmoil in the United States. So I have an analogy. This is us. If you have turmoil within yourself and your relationship with yourself is not going well, how can you relate with other people, Sam?
That's great. If you have agita on the inside.
Exactly.
Focus with yourself.
Right.
How in the world are you going to, like, deal with other people?
Exactly. So I give this analogy to my clients because they don't get it. They feel like, oh, I'm being selfish if I just think of myself first. And a lot of people are thinking, oh, we're being selfish, putting up boundaries around the United States. Basically, what I tell them, there's an analogy when you go on the airplane and the cute little stewardess says to you, if the plane crashes and the oxygen mask comes down, who do you put that oxygen mask on first? Do you put it on the little child next to you, or do you put it on you?
Put it on you.
Of course, because you put it on you because
you need to be able to think clearly and function and take care of others.
Exactly. So that's what Trump is doing right now.
The hell with everyone else.
Well, that's what he's doing right now. Exactly. And we're wanting that. So we already have food, shelter, and all this. So we're into the safety and security part.
Love it.
So that's where we are in this stage. And then number three, we're going to be doing the social where we relate with the other people in the world. For instance, the UN. Okay. So, and my prediction is that he is going to leave the UN. I do predict that. I think that, and we'll talk about that later.
Yeah. And he should. They're discussing a bunch of dirtbag scum over there. Jill Payne, well, our in-house psychotherapist. Yeah. Yes. That was my editorial opinion. All right. So wait a minute. So, yeah.
And then about the Putin, I wanted to talk about Putin because everybody's worried about that. And Trump is, remember we talked about schemas and how he is a CEO and a entrepreneur, a thing like that. And now he has put a schema in for a politician. The way he is going to deal with the United States and the people that he's picked, you can see they're all different. They're not the usual people right in his cabinet.
They're not cookie cutter cases, right? You've got successes in military, successes in business. Success in the private sector, right?
Right.
He's put together quite a diverse group of people.
Right. Now you're going to say, Jill, this is common sense. I'm going to say this to you. They're saying, oh, he's going in bed with Putin. No, you want a win-win situation when you're doing a business deal. And I'm a businesswoman, and so are you, Sam. I am not going to do business with somebody I don't like. My mind will be closed. I'm not even going to listen to you. I'm not a politician. Politicians will do business with people they don't like. Businessman, are you going to do business with somebody that you don't trust, that you don't respect?
No.
No, of course not.
No.
So that's his mindset. His mindset is, I want to make this a win-win situation. So therefore, I need to talk to Putin as though I'm doing a business deal.
And some of the best business deals I've learned is when the other guy walks away feeling good.
Exactly.
Versus he walked away going, oh, I just took it in shorts. Oh, did I just get robbed?
Yes. Oh. Exactly. He needs to believe, it's all perception, that he is also winning.
And you know why? And, for long-term relationships.
Right. So that is what's going on right now. And
love it.
Do you like it?
Oh, no. We're the only show with an in-house psychotherapist, right? It's a total departure from traditional morning radio, conservative talk.
And just one more thing, just so people understand, because you're wondering how come the Democrats are acting this way and how come Trump got elected. And I had this young millennial sit next to me, and she was African-American. We had a wonderful conversation because she was a psychotherapist getting her license. And so she was very open. And by the way, I'm finding the millennials very open because they really were for Bernie Sanders.
Right.
Some didn't even vote. And she even said, so they're very open to how come Trump won. So we had a wonderful 3-hour conversation. But basically, existential anxiety produces anxiety, stress, strife, worry, and even panic. So that's what you're okay. So that's what's happening over that's what's happening with the Democrats. They're in the panic mode. And so we have felt better because a lot of the not all the Republicans, but a lot of the conservatives have gotten what they believe is right. So they're feeling more secure. Still not so secure until he gets into office. So that's what's going on.
Our in-house psychotherapist, Jill Payne, joining us. And people also, you know, it's funny when people comment, they say, Sam, the only time you shut up is when Jill talks. Because I'm like,
oh, I feel honored.
No, I'm learning. I'm like, because then I just take your stuff and I just recycle it the next day. And it's like, he sounds smart. No, it's you. I appreciate it. Jill
Payne. You can use existential anxiety. So now you'll impress people.
Or what I'll do is... Okay, so real quick, y'all know I was thrown out of the public schools in the 8th grade. It is what it is. Whatever. So there was one great teacher, and we used to call him Pasta Chin. But anyway, a great Italian guy, he became a great friend, who taught me about Abraham Maslow, and he had me read The Art of Self-Actualization.
Wow.
And he's like, you know what, you're a punk, but you got a good heart. Instead of fighting all the time, instead of running with that crew, read this book. And he got me to read a book. The Art of Self-Actualization by Abraham Maslow has stuck with me to this day. That teacher died in 2016, a great man. But it's funny you brought that up. I'm like, wow, that just brought up all those memories.
Do you know what? That means if he had you do that, because Maslow only studied the top 1%. He studied only successful people.
Yeah.
And the people that are successful, seriously, do the steps of Maslow.
I read that. It stuck with me forever. The Art of Self-Actualization is fantastic.
There you go. That's how come you're where you are.
And Pasta Chin, I used to call him Pasta Chin. He said, shut up. And he would just say, stop fighting. Stop being a punk. Stop, being a troublemaker. He said, you got a good heart. You're a good kid. Just get your act together. You know, he would grab you, too, by the shirt and pull you in and, like, knock it off. And I was afraid. Anyway, Good to have you aboard. You're the best. You're the best. Jill Painter, in-house psychotherapist. Have a wonderful, blessed Wednesday. I'll talk to you next Wednesday. Same bat time, same bat channel.
I look forward to it, Sam.
You got it, babe. Have a wonderful one.
Have a happy new year.
Until Super Bowl, you can say, Happy New Year! Back in a second.